It just seems to me your thoughts haven't caught up to your instincts yet. And I know something about that. When we get out of here, I'll give you some space. Let you think carefully about whether you're ready for what it means to make this weapon, and to use it. Meanwhile, I'll see what else I can learn while we're here. Maybe I'll send a few Einherjar back to Valhalla for good measure.
Well, you have fun now.
Hey, you made it! About time. I got everything all set here. Now we just gotta push on up to the forge.
Falky!
Fine. Take your fancy dancy shortcuts. Think I don't mind stretching my legs? Catch up with you any damn time I like. Better take out that net, or it'll be Eyeball City out here. So much for following me. Fine. Let's see what you find. Hey, try sticking your hand in that thing.
Red, cool, brown.
It ain't just crop charter. Closing in behind ground! You want some of this? I'll get a taste!
Come on, Kratos! Off your back!
Seek!
I'll have you know that was plagiarized when we found it.
Sure it was. You sure did go to pains coming here, busting old Tyr loose. What a prize he turned out to be, huh? Lucid enough when it's time to steal my kitchen, though.
Forge ahead. Unintended, I imagine.
Hang on. Almost got it. There. Well, come on in, stranger.
I never do get used to that trick.
Locals up ahead. That's civilized, and hopefully nobody springs an alarm. No, quit your nattering, you snake-sucking mummy milk sauce with your protective gear. Ain't you never seen a legend in the flesh before? Well, that ain't no good. You see what's wrong here, don't you? Those creepy flying eyeballs made a nest up on the cables. We gotta figure a way up there and clear them all. Go! Okay, looks like that wheel up there opens the gate. Not that we can reach it. No crap. Why don't you look around, see if there's a way to lift this lift?
Brother, did you notice the dwarves of the camp were twice as alarmed to see Brock than they were to see you?
They did seem surprised.
All right. Now I can turn this crank and cap that geyser there. You just give me the signal when you're ready.
Now.
On it! The other stuff. Look around, find an angle. Ain't this what you do?
Ah, promising.
Turn it.
Copy that. There you go. Right on the mark.
Turn it again.
Aye, aye. Gate's open. Come on through and get those cables clear. They seen it. thing can move. That's why we're up here, remember? Finally! Now we can ride on up to the fort. Come on! The lady's waiting. Hey, got another riddle for you. What gets bigger the more you take away from it?
Well, let's see. Something abstract, I expect.
Appetite? No, that doesn't work.
Stomp the stomp.
Oh, isn't that clever?
Bampot.
Think I'll grab some for the lady.
Grab some what? The wind?
No, you idiot. The sound of the wind.
How?
Watch and learn. See? Dwarven magic's all about the intangibles. The relationship between the stuff what you can touch and what you can't. It's about understanding.
Understanding what?
The nature of a thing's more important than the form of a thing. Hang on! I smell trouble. Show me what you got! Ain't a more magical creature in this whole realm. Why, I've been waiting for my chance to meet her since I was knee-high to Anokin. But Sindri had never had it. Said I was too uncouth. But today's finally the day. Woo! I got goosebumps on my bunions.
Why, bro, I've never seen you so reverent.
Are you nervous?
What? Shut up! No, fuck you! Go on, Pasty! Turn the crank! Let's do this!
It does not work.
Huh? What is it this time? Out of the way! Let me look! Fix everything in this dang city my own self. I'm gonna need a couple of things. Follow me. Yeesh, this place ain't in some disrepair. It's disrespectful, I tell you. I need that axe of ours to go kiss that material out yonder. The spiky, silvery stuff. You'll figure it out.
This lady, what does she do?
Well, we'll see soon enough, won't we? I know this, though. If we're real lucky, she'll give us her blessing. Doesn't give them to every piece, but the ones she does, there's something to behold.
The axe?
Well, that particular process was a whole nother cluster, huh? Maybe sometime I'll spin you that tale. Faye's the only one who ever got my highbrow sense of humor. Damn fine woman she was. Apart from her taste in men, of course. Now I need a chunk of that bronze material over by all that busted up wood. Back in those days, I'd get so caught up in trying to be the best that I'd work till I was strong. Time goes by and there's less to prove. You learn to keep your own pace. Save your extra effort for when it's personal. Like for when you finally get to show the lady who you are. Wow, Goaty, you sure did give up on that riddle in a hurry.
I give up nothing. It gets bigger the more you take away, is it?
That's right.
Sorted. It's desire.
Nope.
What do you mean, nope? Desire only grows when you take away the thing you desire. All right, it's not perfect, but let's hear your answer.
Oh, you won't get it out of me that easy. All right, let's get back to business. One more crank to turn, and it's on to the forge.
I see no forge.
You don't see the form of a forge, but we're going to the nature of one.
I was almost following him for a moment there.
We're good. Crank it.
She needs the final ingredient. The blood of a god. Give her your hand. Thank you.
Kratos, almost forgot. Ma'am, it would be an honor if you might bless it for us. Are you, Hello? Hello? What the fuck was that? She acts like I weren't even here.
Mermaids don't speak to our corporeal bodies. They speak to a part of our soul. A part specifically you might be missing.
Fuck. Fuck! Damn it, Sindri, you lion cat scrubber! I knew it. I died. I fucking died! The fuck you want?
It needs a blessing.
Yeah, well, the one to give us the blessing just fucked off into the tomb.
It needs the blessing of a great blacksmith.
What? No, no, I can't bless shit. I don't have all my soul bits. The blessing wouldn't mean squat.
It is the nature of a thing that matters. Not its form.
All right. May this weapon strike true. May it be wielded with wisdom. May it be put down when its job is done.
Let us return home.
Now you know I can't let you take our new gal home without giving her a twirl. Look, we got volunteers! Good hit, brother. That's the stuff. Ain't your first time with the spear, I reckon.
It is the first weapon I've fought and learned.
What hell? Ain't this just like old times?
I couldn't have put it more forebodingly myself.
She can help us get out of here, too. Yep. Guess we're doing this one boy style.
Listen, I appreciate what you said back there. It's good to have friends when you find out your brother's a rack-scabbing liar.
No doubt he only wished to protect you.
Weren't his call to make. The guy dies, he's got the right to know about it.
Take heart, Brock. We all die sometime. Many of us more than once.
No, never mind all that. We gotta finish putting the spirit through our paces. Come on. Might have to get creative up ahead.
on the left.
Oh, lick my face. There's eyeball nests all over. Get your throwing arm in here.
Oh, above you. Watch out.
Right there. Get the dang nest.
Behind you.
Better take out that nest or it'll be eyeball city out here.
Oh, nasty hit. You all right, brother?
See there? You starting to recognize when there's a weak... Setting off a spear in anything like that's a sure way to alter your circumstances on the right quick. See? You're a natural! Guesses, belt boy.
Oh, all right. Gets bigger the more you take away. Is it time? Because the more removed from events you become, the larger their scope in your memory. No, that's bollocks now that I say it. Never mind.
Today's all right. Them eyeballs are taking over the ground. We better beat them out. Over here!
On your right!
Hey, Bartlett! I don't know what you're waiting for. I'm right here! With those puppies. You want it straight on. Whoa, you sure you ain't done this before?
One of Nito's children. Put it in the trap.
Didn't mean to scare you or anything.
You did not.
Right. You can bring that back to Ratatoskr whenever you're ready.
Ah, that's blocked.
Huh.
favor to ask of the both of you, and we can call a square. What happened down there in the forge with the lady? That's my story to tell, all right?
Agreed.
Well, for a period of time, perhaps.
Mimir.
Very well.
These ugly bugs. Maybe those Grimm will take him down. Nope. Hey, Bartlett! I don't know what you're waiting for. I'm right here. Hey, Bunker! Come on! Find you!
Thank you, Brock. It is a good spear.
Damn straight it is.
Thank you.
reckon I see how you'll be getting down from up here. Best I find my own way back. Been too auspicious a day to And I'll get those gates working for you.
I only hope Sindri's in one piece by the time Brock's done with him. The ice beneath those two is thin enough under the best of circumstances.
Where is everyone?
Now a good time. I just want to talk. Dad to dad. Speaking of which, imagine my surprise when Atreus came knocking at my door. He's doing well, by the way, and will continue to do so just as long as I return to Asgard. Sometime soon. Besides, our friend here has a whole lot to live for.
Arguable.
Run along now, but behave yourself. New spear. Never much cared for Brock. Can't deny the dwarf's talent.
You came to speak. Speak.
You don't really want war. Do you, Kratos? All that blood on your hands? On your son's hands? I want peace as much as you do. Perhaps we can find it together.
He's lying.
I know.
That boy of ours is everything I expected. So clever. Kind. You sure he's yours? A kid. You really ought to be very proud. He is the key to peace in our age, to break free from all this fate and prophecy.
My son is not your key.
Oh, God, do they not have metaphor in your homeland? Or rather, did they? I'm sorry, that's not fair. I know you're not the god you once were. And now is your chance to prove it.
Return my son, or you may meet the god I once was.
And what kind of god is that, Kratos? What do you even know of godhood? In your lifetimes, has anyone ever worshipped you? Ever prayed to you? Can you even imagine that kind of love? No! You don't care about mortals. You don't care about anything beyond yourself. Beyond the monster who kills without cause. You fear what you can never even hope to understand. Is it any wonder that your boy is in no rush to come back to you?
Don't listen to him, brother. He's just trying to get in your head.
Superior bastard. The nerve of him showing up here. At least you rattled him as much as he rattled you.
Good timing. Let's see what Brock made you. Enemy behind you, Kratos! Very nice! Behind you, look out! Left side, incoming!
So that's the weapon? A Draupnir spear?
The Draupnir spear.
Well, any given number of Draupnir spears, I suppose.
Come on, I found a gate. We just need to take the train down.
I do worry, though, if I'm being frank. We've crafted a weapon to kill a god. One could say you're on the verge of returning to form.
Does it scare you, aiding another violent god?
I'm scared for you, brother. That spear could start a war. The war. If that no longer concerns you, then maybe Freya's right. Maybe the giants had you in mind all along.
So this Dropnir spear, you're prepared to use it?
To protect Atreus. I am no one's champion but his, nor no one's god. That may be my form. It is not my nature. Do you understand?
I guess a difference of opinion is hardly the most I'm setting aside for this alliance. As long as the plan is to kill Heimdall, the rest matters little.
There's also the bit of news that Odin has some inkling of what we're up to.
I thought I heard ravens. Damn it. What did he say?
Lies, threats, and more lies. What did you expect?
You think he lies that Atreus is in Asgard?
No. On that, I'm afraid I believe him.
Then the rest matters little.
I saw a gateway near here, overlooking the bay. We can get to it with your spear, I think. This way. Be on guard. I haven't cleared this area.
Another Berserker gravestone.
Old. Prepare for a fight.
Tremble, false god! You never had a chance.
Off your back!
My breath over. His berserker champions even less so. Trash! The lot of them.
Why wait until now to speak of them?
Before, there was nothing to be done. But finding that help changed things.
Big guy.
Speak.
Need you to get something for me. A hammer.
A weapon?
No. A forge hammer. Little thing. Symbol of the old resistance. Guild solidarity, all that. Or it used to be anyway, till the Aesir buried it under that big, gaudy dwarf statue in the bay. Might do the dwarves some good to see it again.
You're not worried that might draw the Einar Jarl's attention?
The old father nearly slit my throat just to get to you. I might be past giving a shit what he thinks. Just find me at the bar when you've got it.
You'll certainly be able to reach new areas in the bay with that spear.
Aye. Might be worth looking for Durlin's hammer while we're at it.
Your choice.
Lungs! No, that's rubbish!
What?
Brock's bloody riddle. What gets bigger the more you take away? I can't let that blue twat beat me!
If you are this upset, he already has.
Meeting the Lady of the Forge brought back some memories. I thought it was only in my homeland you'd see such things.
Mermaids who forge weapons.
Aye. I remember very fondly a lady called Nimue. Very talented.
We're here.
I meant that, literally. Shame on you. She made the best swords in all the Isles and had big dreams about what she'd do with them one day. I wonder what became of her. That relic. Do you suppose it's the one we read about? Something to counteract a sleeping curse.
After he was burned by the Aesir mob.
Yes. It haunted him for a long time. It doesn't excuse what he said at my wedding, but I do understand where his anger came from.
You make the spear? Wait, no. Brock has to be the one to tell me what happened. I'm just gonna pretend I was never here.
Thanks for grabbing that for us.
That oughta hurt him. Anything for Freya? Something in mind? What can I make for you? Anything more to discuss? Let's see.
Lady, I was curious about some of the flora we've encountered on our travels.
And you will remain curious. It's not my job to teach you everything, Mimir.
Look, I was just asking.
And you have been told.
Well, you can say that again.
Now, attack!
Save yourself an opening! Don't waste it!
Keep on it!
Freya, where is Sigrun now?
Impossible to say. She's on a mission spanning the realms in search of our lost sisters. Our hope is if she can bring their incorporeal spirits to Vanaheim, we can find a way to restore them to uncorrupted forms.
Incoming fire!
Behind you! Incoming!
That's all of them.
These were coal raiders. Infamous for
eating wolves. Atreus and I have rescued ours from such an encampment.
That was kind of you. The coal raiders have been a blight on this land. The way they've abused its creatures. Perhaps we should do something about it.
Perhaps.
Freya, there's something I've always wanted to ask. What was it Grimthor whispered to you?
Who?
Grimthor, the son of Thormur, the stonemason, who disguised himself and built Asgard's wall.
Oh, yes. One of the many occasions Odin saw fit to involve me in a wager without my consent. I wish I could say that was the worst of his husbandly habits.
Thor, what is that?
That must be Tyr's helmet from his statue.
Win mines, not wars.
Tyr understood the greatest fight of them all was the battle for people's hearts and minds. Too bad Tyr has no interest in doing either these days. Now, if we could get back to the story of Hrimthur, the stonemason's son. I was hoping to get Freya's version of what happened.
There isn't that much to tell. I knew nothing of it at first, surely because Odin didn't expect to lose the bet. A mysterious mason had to build the entire wall in 3 turns of the season.
Two! It was two!
And if he was late, he'd be owed nothing. But if he succeeded, he was promised an audience with the queen. Or so I learned one day when Odin burst into our bedchambers, raging and half-drunk before noon, telling me to get dressed and go see what the mason wants. So, off I went, not knowing what had truly been promised or expected. Dagger stashed in my robe for emergency. And this mason, this giant in disguise...
His name was Hrimthur!
He just smiled to see me. And as you said, he whispered in my ear. He said the Aesir had killed his father, and he needed to know that one day they'd burn for it. I pointed out I was Aesir now too, technically. He gave me a look, as if he somehow knew better, and continued. He said he'd built in a structural flaw behind the Asgard Realm Tower.
I knew it! How do we make use of it?
We don't. He said Surtur would know what to do. And if Surtur's approaching Asgard's wall...
Then it is already Ragnarok.
Aye. Blast it. I hoped it might have given us another way.
Look. There's some debris over there. I'm guessing from Tyr's poor statue.
Defend the peace.
I remember the Jotnar crafting these bracers for Tyr's statue. They chose only their most talented and accomplished to do the job.
You have a good memory, Freya. Like Tyr, the Jotnar also believe the best offensive strategy is a good defense. So, this is how they chose to honor him.
The giants were not wrong.
Brother, about the oracles of your lands, would you say they manipulated events? Did they have an agenda?
I do not doubt they held their own interests first, but in my experience, they could be easily fooled by their own prophecies.
Would that be a specific experience, brother?
Once, I sought the oracle for a means to grant my bondage to Ares. One priestess had visions that showed her Olympus would be brought to ruin by the god of war. Therefore, she helped me, intending to undermine Ares and protect her realm. She did not foresee that I would kill him and take his office. In the end, I proved her vision of doom correct.
So the Oracle herself brought about the very future she hoped to avoid. I suppose we're in fine company at that.
Isn't that the spear from Tyr's statue?
Wish for peace. Be ready for war.
Well, I think that's the last of it. Doubtful we'll find any more interesting bits.
I always admired the love Tyr inspired.
Where I come from, gods of war are not revered in such a way.
Not all gods of war are the same, brother.
No, they are not.
Fuck!
Yellow one. What is it? Where did it come from?
It's a very loud horn, and I've not the faintest idea.
Mimir.
No, truly. No one knows where the yellow horn originated. Odin just gained possession of it one day.
Kratos. A raider and captain.
Shall we take care of them, brother?
Still whine.
Poor things. They can smell more danger.
The wolves fear that which can no longer hurt them.
The horrors of our past can be inextricable from the present. You have to understand that.
Circling back to the topic of prophecies brought about by the efforts to avoid them, I think I can recall such a story as you mentioned, brother. A Greek tale for the stage. Rather lurid, but very popular. You know the one?
Every Greek knows the tragedy of the Theban king.
Yeah, word gets around about that sort of thing.
Another coal raider camp. Kratos, we should do something about them. Tired of your lack of empathy for your own wolves.
It's Deimos, isn't it, brother?
I should not have told you of Deimos.
You see yourself in these wolves, in their fear.
Let us keep moving.
Something else I recall about that Greek play I mentioned, if you won't take offense at a critique. As a work of performance, it consisted almost entirely of watching people give speeches and receive terrible news. Might have been nice to see more events dramatized instead of described.
It is Greek tradition for a story to unfold in a single time and place uninterrupted. It is more clear.
If you say so.
Look, another coal raider camp. We should do something about them and put your wolves at ease.
Enemies on the left!
Take fire!
Kratos, their chieftain.
Raider on the left.
Switching. Kratos, their chieftain. You freed them?
I do not know.
Regardless, they should draw some comfort from his death.
Thank you.
They're still scared.
Not of the Raiders. Do not be afraid. You are safe. Good. Good boys.
Girls.
Good girls.
Did you make the spear? Wait, no. Brock has to be the one to tell me what happened. I'm just gonna pretend I was never here.
How would Atreus get to Asgard?
I'm sorry, but you'd have to ask Odin. He's got control of every path. I know how highly you esteem our expertise on such things, so I'm sure that's disappointing. He's just been one step ahead of us. Strike true.
Now that you have a weapon to deal with Heimdall, we just need to find a way to get to him.
Aye, if that's still the plan.
It is. I will protect my son.
So, then it seems the original plan to avoid Ragnarok has fallen a bit by the wayside.
That is up to Odin.
Yes, that's rather what concerns me. Listen, brother. Those things he said to you...
His words are nothing.
True. Though I expect retaliation is no empty threat. We need to think through the ins and outs of it.
You're getting ahead of yourself. Let's see if Sindri has had any luck.
Do the thing!
Oh, look at that! She's special, that one.
Ain't gotta tell me.
Have you found a way to reach Asgard?
Not as such. Had a few ideas, but they didn't so much work.
Brother, without a way to Asgard, what are we doing?
I do not know. I need to think. I am tired.
So, you're sure nothing unusual happened with the lady? Nothing at all?
Nothing, whatever. Smooth as snail shit, like you said. Why? Some reason you're expecting.
Where are you going, brother?
What? No. Sleep.
So, we're just keeping blindly on then. Hoping we don't walk headlong into Ragnarok. Is that your plan?
You all right?